Hey beauties, today I'm doing a Walmart haul. Lots of head-to-toe outfits, a few accessories, men's and kids' finds. So, if you are new to my channel, my name is DeAndra. I post lots of fashion and beauty content, all of which is always affordable. So, hit that subscribe button and let's get started with this Walmart haul. And here we have outfit number one. You guys, I'm so obsessed with this look. Pretty much head to toe Walmart, except for the booties. These are Sam Edelman Winona booties that I was obsessed with last year. I found them at Nordstrom Rack on sale. I love the Western vibe of these. So here are the hoop earrings. These are quickly becoming my go-to earring. They're so lightweight. They have the cutest texture and they do not look like $3 earrings at all. Pull my little necklace out. This top, you guys, is amazing. It is by the brand Scoop. I did find this one online. As soon as I saw it, I fell in love, first of all, but I knew it was something that I could wear right now in the fall, but I could easily transition this into springtime with a cute pair of cutoff denim. Look at all the texture in that sweater. I love it. It looks so high end. It's lightweight. It's super soft and comfortable. I'm between a small and a medium. I did go with the small on this one because of the sleeves. So if you're in between sizes, I would say size down. These are easily my favorite jeans from Walmart. I've had them forever now, probably over a year, and I still wear them all the time. They're soft, they're stretchy, they're very, very high-waisted. All the distressed detailing on these make them look so high-end. The color on this is perfect. The exposed buttons, super cute. I am not even kidding when I tell you guys this outfit is Walmart head to toe. Funny thing about this jacket is that the first time I saw it, I fell in love. I should have bought it. I knew I should have bought it and I thought it was gone forever because I could not find it online or in store. Went to a different store and found it fully in stock and I was so excited. But this one does also come in a regular denim color. This is a No Boundaries. I love all the distressing on this. This was like 20 bucks and it looks so good. I went with the small, it's oversized. I've tried it on with the sweater. It does fit me with a sweater on as well, very comfortably. If you are going for that like extremely oversized, definitely size up, but it does run oversized already. And this buffalo plaid top is by Time and True. This one's actually from last year. But I did see that they brought it back this year and I was so happy they did because it was like my go-to plaid last year. They also brought it in a red and black colorway, which I almost bought. Now y'all can see this better. So the one that I have on now is a size small. If I was buying it this year, I probably would have sized up just because, you know, I just had a baby and I'm a size bigger this year. I mean, it still fits me. I just probably would wanted it to be, you know, oversized and even more cozy. Maybe I should go back and get the red one in like a large. I might do that, actually, now that I think about it. But this one is so cute. I wore it so much. It held up well. It does have that. But I do just typically fold the cuff and style it like that. So these jeans are the high-rise jeans by No Boundaries. I did need a pair of good jeans for the winter. And I really, really love these. These are actually the $14 ones because I do have a pair of the $9 ones and I just wanted to see what the difference was. So these are a little bit more structured than the $9 ones that I have in black. I will show you those in a second. They're thicker, they feel more high end, and they're still really comfortable. A slight stretch, but not like too much stretch. Very high waisted, it does go over my belly button. They are kind of long for me being 5'1", but you know, they were 15 bucks. I don't mind just cutting off the bottom and having a distressed hem. I really love these, you guys. I feel like everyone sleeps on No Boundaries jeans. I hardly ever hear people talk about them, but they are my favorite jeans to buy from Walmart. They're the most affordable and they're great. And then the boots, you probably have seen these already. I'm obsessed with these. I saw them in store in the tan color, was tempted to buy them, but you know, I have that brown pair that I still haven't even worn, so I refrained, but the black pair are so cute. They do also come in an olive. I wanted to show you guys a slightly more dressed up look. I love this outfit. It is such a fun holiday outfit. I totally would wear this on Thanksgiving Day. The sweater is like an emerald green color. It's by Sofia Vergara. It's actually a bodysuit, which I really like. The material is so soft. I love the statement sleeves. They do have a pleating up here, if you can see that, but I do also like how it comes tighter closer to the wrist. It helps me show off my bracelet stack, which I like. It's a very thin sweater, but it's also very warm. By the way, it is a thong bodysuit, which is nice if you're wearing, you know, any kind of satin skirt or anything like that. You're not gonna get any lines, so that's nice. These are the $9 jeans I was just talking about by No Boundaries. You will find these on the table. I love how high rise these are. They do go over my belly button. I always just get them in the black because I feel like that's the chicest color. The other colors kind of look like $9 jeans, you know, but can't go wrong with black. I wear these all the time. They're so comfortable and stretchy, whereas the other ones that I just showed you, they are gonna be more constricting, like a jean. These are more like a jegging feeling. Don't dry them because the black does fade. Also, I don't know if they still carry the exposed button ones. I haven't seen them online and I haven't seen them in my store. I just love how high-waisted they are and also how comfortable they are and how cheap they are. So check, check, check. The booties are not from Walmart, but I wanna say Time and True does have a pair of black and white snakeskin booties. So if they do, I will link them. Also, these exact ones that I'm wearing now, they're the Soul Naturalizer brand. I got them at DSW, but I did find these on Amazon for like 20 bucks. So I'll link the exact ones, and then if Walmart has them, I'll link those too. Little Miss Lola wanted her screen time. So we have another head-to-toe outfit here, and I'm obsessed with this look. This jacket, it is by Time and True and it's amazing. I have been on the hunt for something like this for so long, while also trying to find it in an affordable price. Has been a struggle. So when I came across this one at Walmart, I bought it immediately. Love the darker denim on this. It is fully lined with Sherpa all the way around, so it's really, really warm. The inside of the sleeves down my arm isn't. It's more of a normal jacket lining, but you know, all that matters is the wrist. And that does have Sherpa detailing on it, as well as the pockets do have Sherpa lining. I think that is so cute. I actually went with a small in this one as well, just because I didn't want it to be too oversized and boxy. But again, if that's the vibe that you're going for, definitely sized up, but it does already have an oversized look to it. This tank top is one of the $2 tank tops from No Boundaries. I really love these. They're ribbed, and then I like the way the tank actually looks, like the detailing on that. These jeans are the same $15 No Boundaries jeans that I showed you in the normal denim color. I went ahead and picked them up in a black pair just because I wear a lot of black jeans during the fall and winter. The black pair actually doesn't seem as long as the denim pair did. I did pick up these Time and True ones, the like sock booty one. I figured these were such a great closet staple. I don't have black booties that have a heel to it. Actually, I mostly just have like everyday black booties. So I needed a pair, and These were so popular last year that I had to try them out myself. I am totally on board with the brown trend. I fell in love with this little long sleeve top when I saw it in store. This is by Time and True, by the way. I did size up to a medium on this one as well, just because I wanted it oversized and cozy. I wanted to be able to wear it with leggings, no problem. So, you know, it is a high-low hem. Really love that. Definitely long enough for leggings. I also like that it's a split hem as well. This one is very similar to their pullovers that everyone goes crazy over, but it is a more dressy material and even softer. This material is so amazing and buttery soft. I really love all the detailing in this. Like, why are my bra lines showing? That's kind of annoying. Makes a note to buy a better bra, but I do really like the stitching down the middle. I think that's so cute. The drop sleeve is adorable, and then it does also have the detailing in the wrist right here, which you can kind of see on this hand, but you can see like the length. You know, you guys, my arms are short. I'm 5'1", so all my sleeves scrunch. Did size up in this one for a more roomy fit, and I absolutely love it. I'm just in the same pair of high-waisted, no boundaries jeans, and these booties are from Amazon. I'm obsessed with them. They were so affordable, and they're gorgeous in person. The heel is very practical, and I really like the cutout. The heel actually is like an angled, if you can see that. It's like kind of angled, which I really, really like. Anyways, I'm obsessed with these booties. Y'all, this pink sweater is so amazing. It's actually by Scoop, and I did find this one online. I'm obsessed with this like neon pink color. It's gorgeous. The material is so, so soft, and I love all the detailing in the arms. I love that it's a V-neck. It's oversized. It's comfortable. I did size up to a medium on this one. Should probably fix my pocket. I'll untuck it so you guys can see. Not quite long enough to wear with leggings on its own. Definitely a top you could dress up or dress down. And then these jeans are no boundaries jeans. This video is basically me trying to make no boundaries jeans happen. I found these on clearance at my Walmart for $3, you guys. I ran to Instagram immediately to let you guys know to go shop these in store because I could not find them online, and they do come in a really pretty black color. So if you see these in store, scoop them up. They fit so good. They make me feel so snatched. You know, I just had a baby. I kind of really don't feel snatched right now, but when I put these jeans on, I do. And I've worn them so many times since I got them. I love the busted out knee detail. The booties are not from Walmart. They are Mark Fisher though, and I did find them at Ross. I don't do a lot of Ross content here on YouTube, but I do a lot of shop with me's over on Instagram. So if you're thinking about following me on Instagram and you haven't, you totally should. Some of y'all might think I'm slightly crazy, but I don't know. Some of y'all might understand. This outfit is a recreation of a outfit that J.Lo wore in the Selena movie. It's the scene where they were talking about how she wanted a farm and all her farm animals. If y'all are as obsessed with Selena as I am, y'all know what I'm talking about. But for some reason, I've always been obsessed with that outfit where she's wearing the leggings with the striped and that like huge oversized red tee and the hat and the hoops. I'm not even gonna lie that when I saw these online, I was like, yes, those are perfect to recreate that outfit. I couldn't find a top that I really liked on Walmart, so I went to Amazon and I found this one. It was perfect, and I sure did recreate an outfit from the movie Selena, and I love it. I don't even care. I love it. I will be wearing this outfit nonstop. These Champion leggings are from Walmart, and you guys, they are amazing. They are the first pair of leggings ever in my entire life that fit me at the ankle perfectly, but they are very stretchy, very comfortable. They're a good pair of Champion leggings. And then for the tennis shoes, these are from my Shein haul. They are Yeezy dupes. They're so lightweight and comfortable. It doesn't even feel like I'm wearing shoes. Look for less. That's what my channel's all about. Same leggings, different top and shoes, but I'm really loving this outfit as well. This pullover, you guys, is so amazing. I think it's by the brand Avis. I don't know if I'm saying that right. I love this quilted detail right here. It looks so high-end. It's very comfortable. It is a like kangaroo pouch style pocket, but I really, really, really love this pullover. So many different color options, by the way. I also love that when you zip it up, it hides the zipper. It is a stretchy, dry fit material. Did grab this in a medium. I think it looks so good and so much more expensive than it was. I just paired it with the same leggings and my Reebok Classics. I've been loving these. Good grocery store outfit for sure. Head to toe, Walmart outfit, shoes included. Not jewelry. Jewelry is still very affordable though. It is from Amazon as well as my bracelet stack. I will link everything down in the description box. But of course I still have these hoops on. The sweater is by Time and True. And I actually found this one in store. Love, love, love this, you guys. It's so, so soft. I love all the different textures. I like the way that the arm sleeves get tighter after the drop shoulder. I like the detailing in the V-neck, how it kind of overlaps. It is a high-low sweater, which I really, really love. Perfect for leggings. I did size up to a medium on this one. I don't do gray a lot, but when I find a good gray, I buy it, I scoop it up, and I wear the heck out of it. And then these faux leather leggings, I bought in hopes that they would be a Spanx dupe, but actually, you guys, these are closer to the Nordstrom BP. They do have a fleece lining. The top waistband looks exactly like the BP ones. I do have the Nordstrom BP pair, and I did a side-by-side on my Instagram stories. So if you don't follow me on Instagram, go follow me now so that you don't miss side-by-side comparisons like that, because I do that a lot over on Instagram. And I will save a highlight if you guys are curious, because I was able to show y'all the inside and, you know, all the waistband details and all of that. I am 5'1", so they do bunch at the bottom. So these shoes I did also mention in my last Walmart haul. I found these online. They are a platform snakeskin sneaker by Time and True. They run true to size. They do have the memory foam, just like all the other Time and True Slip-on tennis shoes do. As always, I wanted to show you guys some things that I got accessories-wise, but I also wanted to share some things I bought for Josh and the boys, because I do find some good stuff at Walmart for them as well. So I'll show you the boys' hats. So this one, it just reminds me of like a Columbia hat. I really, really like that graphic on there. And then of course, Brayden picked this one out, all the dinosaurs. These were between $5 and $6. This one I had to get Brayden as well. I thought that was so cute. Love the maroon and gray. Great colors for the fall time. It is a little trucker hat. I just love the buffalo plaid on this one. I need to lint roll it, but it's like a faux suede. An adjustable back, super cute. Great for the winter, for the holidays. The Wrangler vest I got for Josh. This one did come in a black, chocolate brown, that yellowish, brownish color that's popular with these types of brands. The inside seems pretty warm. It's not that thick at all. I love the gray hoodie on it, the pockets on the chest, and then the pockets here. It's nice. It looks good on him too. It runs true to size. These are the two earrings that I found. I really, really loved these hoops. I thought that they were so cute with the texture on it. $288, you guys. You cannot beat that. at. And then these ear crawlers, really pretty. I've had some jewelry in the Time and True brand and it's always really great quality. And then we have these slippers, which I did find these online. I liked the gold on the outside. They remind me of a pair of Uggs, very thick and comfortable, and a great Ugg dupe if you're wanting something that has a thicker sole like this. The infamous Daisy Rose, that's the brand, right? Yes, Daisy Rose checkered makeup bag. I've seen this on several people's videos. It's actually really nice. I've had it for a while. I just didn't want to take the tag off so I could show you guys the brand, but it has the gold zipper. It's got a lot of storage space, actually. I like that it has the handle. Very sturdy. As you can see, it does stand up on its own, no problem. I did want to mention that I picked up a two-pack of these slimming seam-free two-pack thongs. I just needed something. If you didn't know, I just had a baby. She's like 3 months old. You can probably hear her talking in the background too. And these are actually very comfortable, a great price. I think I paid like $8 or $9 for the two-pack. And yeah, so I wanted to share those. If you need to binge more content, I'll leave two videos right over here. I do lots of Walmart, Amazon, Shein, and wow, I really need to step out of my comfort zone. So if you have a suggestion on where you want me to shop next, leave it down in the comments. Thank you guys so, so much for watching, and I'll see y'all next time. Bye-bye.